Good morning, students. Today we'll start with the last topic of the session, that is green scales. What do we mean by green scales? Green scale is having a concern about an environment, environmental science, trying to get closer to the nature. Now, what is environment? Environment is the place, people, things, and nature that surround any living organism. It is our basic life support system. It includes two components, biotic and abiotic. What are biotic components? Biotic includes all the human being, plants, animals, microbes. What are abiotic components? It includes light, air, water, soil. This abiotic components also includes atmosphere, biosphere, lithosphere, hydrosphere. Now students will see a relationship between society and environment. All the human, environment and society are actually interrelated with each other. They have a bonding and dependency with each other. Society is in turn becomes part of environment. The relationship has some categories. First, we'll see the physical environment. What is physical environment? It is composed of those conditions that nature provides for men. It includes earth's surface with all its physical features and natural, climatic and all cosmetic forces. Now, we will see what is social environment. It consists of three kinds of environment: economic, cultural and psychosocial. Now, students, tell me, what is economic environment? Economic environment is concerned with the goods, houses, roads, machines, animals. What is cultural environment? It includes customs, traditions, laws, modes of thoughts, and form of knowledge. And then, what is psychosocial environment? It refers to culture and climate of the workspace. It is most pervasive of all the environment and is so necessary to the life of a man that can be totally explained in terms of society. That means, when we talk about environment, this environment is composed of three factors, that is economic, cultural and psychological, that is psychosocial. And all these three plays an important role in forming an environment. Now, what is ecosystem? It is a community of living organisms in conjunction with non-living components. So, when we talk about ecosystem, it is nothing but the relationship between biotic or abiotic livings with non-living things. Ecosystem can be put into two groups, aquatic and terrestrial. Now, what do you mean by aquatic ecosystem? Aquatic ecosystem is an ecosystem which is concerned with water, and terrestrial ecosystem is concerned with land. Now, this ecosystem are again broadly categorized into natural ecosystem and artificial ecosystem. In natural, we have seen what is aquatic and what is terrestrial. Again, in aquatic, we can have two categories, that is freshwater ecosystem and marine water ecosystem. Then, in artificial ecosystem, we have again two categories, that is land ecosystem and freshwater ecosystem. A small world into a big world forms an ecosystem. Now we will turn or will emphasis on what is artificial ecosystem. There are natural regions affected by man's interference. The artificial lakes, reservoirs, township, cities, this all which has been formed artificially comes under artificial ecosystem. Now we'll turn towards natural ecosystem. Natural ecosystem is categorized into terrestrial and aquatic. Now, what is terrestrial? Terrestrial means this is land-based. So, forest, desert, grassland, mountains, this all forms terrestrial ecosystem. Water ecosystem consists of freshwater, marine water. Freshwater ecosystem, 0.8% has been covered with the freshwater. 0.09% of total water is being used under this. This type of freshwater ecosystem consists of lentic, that is slow moving or still water like pools, lakes or ponds. Lotic, fast moving water such as streams and rivers. Now, we are very much concerned about, till now we have seen students what is environment, then the relationship between environment and society, what is ecosystem, natural and artificial ecosystem. Now, we will emphasize on factors which are causing environment imbalance. So, which factors cause problem for an environment? Very main causes are overpopulation. See, as the population increase, the demand increase. So it is the root cause for global warming, environmental pollution, habitat loss. Then the second cause is landfills. Landfills is where we put our garbage and other waste materials. So as the population increases, the amount of garbage increases. The garbage increases, the amount of dumping the garbage in the land increases, which causes landfills, which also causes air pollution, soil erosion. Then bad agricultural practices. As the demand for food has increased, the demand for chemical fertilizers have got increased. Now the farmers have started using artificial, that is chemical fertilizers, which causes groundwater contamination. Then the next cause is industrial waste. As the industries are getting developed, many of the industries are not eco-friendly. So what happens is they leave all the waste, industrial waste, in the river, land or soil or water, which makes them polluted. Use of polythene and plastic is also a cause of environmental imbalance. See, students, plastic is non-biodegradable waste. If you keep using plastic, it will keep spoiling your land. Next is deforestation. What is deforestation? Cutting down of trees, which causes soil erosion, which causes increase in the temperature, and many more root causes. Now, we will turn towards the natural resource conservation. See, till now we have seen this all are the causes of environment imbalance. Now, we will try to find out some of the solutions for environmental imbalance. So, for having a natural resource conservation, we need to emphasize on first is renewable sources. Now, what are renewable sources? The sources which are easily available. So, the sources like solar energy, wind energy, these all are renewable sources. Now, as we know, there are non-renewable sources as well. So, which are non-renewable sources? Fossil fuels, kerosene, petrol, soil, stone, oil, coal, gases, these all are non-renewable sources. How to conserve these natural resources? We should have proper domestic use. So first, in natural resources, we will concentrate on how to conserve water, how to preserve water. One is recycling of industrial water. Wastewater treatments. See, there are some plants near chemical industries like CETP in our Lote, where the wastewater is being filtered, recycled, and been reused. Then by increasing and making mandatory miniatures, check dams, grassroots irrigation, effective agricultural use, proper domestic use. Now we will turn towards conservation of wildlife animals, aquatic life. Educate people about wildlife safety, donate to wildlife charities, establish national parks, and stop wildlife related tourism and hunting. So as we are excited to go in a jungle, make sure that you are not harming, you are not hurting the animals. Next, we will see what is conservation of forest. Stop deforestation, that is stop cutting down of trees, try to plant trees, protection of existing forest, forest clearance for agriculture should be stopped, conservation of threatened species of trees should be done. Now we will see how do we conserve the fossil fuels. See, fossil fuels are non-renewable sources of energy. So as we will keep on using them, it takes millions of years to form one layer of a fossil fuel. So we should try to use renewable energy sources like wind, solar energy, water instead of fossil fuels. Use more solar panels to make renewable solar energy. Alternative sources of energy should be opted. Use traditional gobar gas for producing flammable gases. So instead of using LPG gas, instead of using kerosene, petroleum, we should try to find out some of the solution which will conserve our fossil fuels. Now we will turn towards the last part, that is environment protection and conservation. Plant trees where trees absorb carbon dioxide or greenhouse gases. When shopping, look for recycling process or symbol on packaging. Use recycling products. So the products which have recycling, the three arrows which are interconnected with each other, which shows the symbol of recycling. Turn off your home gadgets when they are not in use. Okay, students, so far we have learned about the green skills. We have seen what is environment, physical environment. Then we have seen what is ecosystem, relationship between environment and society. Under ecosystem, we have seen natural, artificial ecosystem. Then we have seen the factors which are causing environment imbalance. Then we have turned towards conservation of water, fossil fuels, forest, aquatic life, wildlife. So you all have been requested to go through the textbook notes. Solve the exercise in your notebook.